last episode on sailing Millennial Falcon, we flew from Hamilton Island to hang out with my family in Gold Coast. We explored the mountains and the coast of Gold Coast, but also followed up on some boat chores, like getting our chain plates remade. We then headed from Gold Coast on our journey back to Puerto Rico, where we'd put Millie to bed. So we're back in the marina now, and I thought I'd try putting on the gear linkage onto our gears, obviously. So we'll see how it goes. Hopefully worse, because we actually don't have a backup if this thing doesn't fit. So
well, good, it might actually fit pretty well.
How good?
We've done well. We've done very well. So these were done by a marine caster, and my original plan was to get an aluminium billet and just grind it, drill it, and fix it up, which is kind of how it's ended up going in the end. But this is much, much closer to the original than I possibly could have done.
Almost $250 Australian.
$50 Australian. $2 for $50. And now we've got a split pin through it, so it doesn't have to use that stupid little a little key thing that goes on the shaft, which is why it broke in the first place. So we're cooking with gas. Cool.
All right, moment of truth. Put it together. Fits like a glove, so good luck with this. Yes! Oh, look at that! Oh, it's so good!
Like you've bought one.
Oh my god! Look! Oh my god, we have forward, reverse, and neutral again!
Oh.
Yes!
Oh, it's so good. It's infinitely better than a hacksaw.
Oh, definitely. Yes!
I've got my sewing bug on after making the pillows when I was back in Australia at home. I've come back and I'm like, okay, need to get started on the sail pack. So we've had this material just around, we bought it in America a couple of months ago, and I actually haven't done anything with it so far. I've just cut it out. So finally, I've got up the sewing machine, set it all up, and now I'm trying to measure ridiculous amounts of material in the tiniest space possible. This is really hard.
Show them the ones you made, the pillows you made today.
Oh yeah, I didn't make them. But these are my final pillows. Whee! And then these ones too.
Just as a side note for everyone playing at home, she's been up since 3 a.m. with jet lag. There's something wrong with her.
It's only 4 p.m. though, so I'll probably crash in about an hour. But until then, I'm doing right, I'm being productive.
So I don't know if you remember us saying previously that when we were traveling, we flew from Australia to Puerto Rico, and the airline who we flew with for half of the journey, they lost 2 out of 4 of our suitcases. So I've just got a call from them, and they said that they found one of the suitcases, which thankfully, thank God, is the suitcase which had the 3 chain plates in. So I'm so, so glad that one is the one that's coming back to us. They're going to post over FedEx Express, so it should be here tomorrow, which is such a relief. It's ridiculous. The other one that we're still waiting on, though, hopefully they find that one, is the one which has all of my clothes in there. So pretty much majority of the clothes I own went to and from Australia, so they were in that suitcase, and that one's been lost. So obviously isn't as important, but I really, really hope they find that one too.
Thankfully, the luggage arrived and we were able to start replacing the chain plates.
How are you doing?
I'm pretty hot. And some genius just turned the oven over on.
Yeah.
Beneath where I'm working.
Totally wasn't me. But I do believe that this is the 5th out of the 6 chain plate that's going back in. All of them seem to have fit from one, which conveniently is the one that we only made one of two. One of. So that's pretty good. We'll see how this chain plate fits though. Alright, it's really hard to see in this light, but it's looking good. The sail pack has I guess worked for now until we see it in the daylight, and then we might decide otherwise. But it looks pretty good in the kind of darkness.
Explode.
Happy. Very happy, and we're going for a celebratory beer. I'm going up the mast today. Need to reattach the lazy jack lines. Safety line.
rookie mistake.
Wave hello. I'm about 3/4 of the way at the mast, and I just had to put on our lazy jack lines as they came out a couple of months ago. Anyway, after finishing off the sail pack, we obviously need the lazy jack lines now. I'm a little bit nervous, I will admit, and I'm clutching to this GoPro with my life, and to the mast with my life, because it is my life. But it's pretty cool. And now heading back down, I really hope that Adam doesn't drop me. Ah, I'm back. You totally did that on purpose.
No.
Oh my god. I'm back on flatland, but I'm still shaking from being dropped. It looks quite good. I still need to do the back of it. But it looks quite good.
We rented a car from the marina, and now we're going to head to do a few chores. So we're going to go to Home Depot first. We're going to get some tools from there, and then from there we're going to head to a boat graveyard. Apparently all the boats that were in the hurricane that didn't get claimed have been, hauled up? Been collected, hauled up by this guy, and he's storing them in a lot out in Ponce. So we're going to go there and try and find a hard cover for our hard Bimini top for our boat. And with our tools, we might be able to get it down. So fingers crossed we find something. Otherwise, unfortunately, I think I'm sewing one.
Absolute chaos.
So what are your thoughts on the graveyard?
Yeah, the great. There was one potential candidate there, but it was like really well built into the structure, and the like. I don't really trust the damage that the panel had taken, and so I feel that it's in this case we would have been better off just building one like a low key sort of foam board, fiberglass laminate, flat top, hard roof, instead of cutting and re fiberglassing up an existing panel off some wreck.
So we are back to Home Depot after we've just come from Home Depot. On a suitcase update, they've well and truly lost one of our suitcases. I spoke to the person the other day on the phone from Qantas, and she was just like, yeah, we've lost it. There was like no trying to hide it. She was just like, yep, can't find it. So that has all of my clothes in. It has his computer, so much stuff in there, and they've just lost it, can't find it.
What are you doing over there, Mrs. Sewing Extraordinaire?
That's such good progress.
Seamstress.
With my sail pack, but I thought I'd attempt the dodger again while we're on shore power, and I'll try and smash that as quickly as possible so that we don't stay in the marina too long. But I'm creating a pattern for our new dodger.
What? Yeah, spray dodger.
Yeah. If you're doing sailing on the cheap, then probably you wouldn't be changing your dodger, but if you're doing sailing on the cheap and you don't want to pay for a new dodger, this is the way to go. Sail right.
Buy a boat with a dodger that works. Nah, dead set, don't buy a boat with a dodger that works. Because as far as boats go, the dodger and the bags and the Bimini is like, it's low key repairs.
Yeah, you're probably right.
Suffered our biggest technical malfunction of the entire journey so far. I don't know how we're going to recover from this one. It's pretty serious. I don't think there's any coming back.
Do, do, do. Put a crack in the coffee pot. When I was cleaning it, I banged it a bit too hard. And now we cannot make coffee this morning. I just don't know how we're going to cope.
Cancel everything. Sell the boat.
Day's cancelled.
We're going
home. Go back to Australia.
It's been real, guys. Thank you for watching. Thank you for joining us. But the journey can go no further. Can go no further until coffee is reinstated. We just can't do it.
So today we have pretty much torn apart all the shelter in the cockpit. Kiara's begun the task of building a new spray dodger after the fashion of our new sail bag, and before we get done finishing that up, we are going to build a new hardtop Bimini roof out of PVC foam board and fiberglass. One of the neighbors down the way, Mike, has been instrumental in helping me figure out how to build that. He actually built the Bimini on this this boat next door to us, and it looks really good, and it's quite easy, it's quite fast, it's quite cheap, and it'll go on the existing frame because it's not too heavy. So that's going to be an awesome sort of interim slash semi-permanent solution to our current lack of shelter. So it's going to be a fun day.
We then fiberglassed the middle section of PVC foam and left the outer edges plain so that we could bend them later to fit our Bimini frame.
So we have the top of the new Bimini cover on. It was a little bit of a struggle this morning, and so obviously we couldn't film because we needed all hands on deck. But yeah, now I'm measuring it up, making sure it's even on all sides. And when I say we, I mean Adamus and I'm pink.
Having made sure that everything lined up, we then curved the edges with a heat gun. Having bent the panel into shape, we then fiberglassed the edges and let it dry.
Adam's cheating on Millie. Who are you cheating on her with?
I'm not cheating on her, I'm just checking out another boat. So
she's right there. She is just right there.
And
she can hear
lovely,
you.
She's lovely and I love her and she's beautiful. It doesn't mean I can't appreciate other boats.
Mm-hmm.
We are talking about boats, as a matter of fact. Just for the record, this is not a metaphor.
He was practically drooling.
There's an Amel 54 over there and it is just beautiful. I can't fault it. I've always loved catches because they just look really... They're just a beautiful configuration. It's mm-hmm. got a staysail. It's got a decent head. It's got roller fillers front and back. It's got a nice dry center cockpit. It's got a massive aft cabin that I can see there.
Is this going to be our upgrade?
Space. I don't know. That could be the Millennial Falcon.
When we have
too.
50 jobs and...
Who makes Amel, right? Amel makes them, or is that the name of the...
I don't know.
I assume the company is called Amel. Get in touch, Amel. 200 subscribers, you know. Can't afford to go past that kind of advertising. I'm happy to plug one for you, mate. So I haven't explained this actually, and you've just given me a window with which to do it. It's a plug, or a, I don't know. Just it's the first time that I've made like really like quite good friends with another cruiser, or a couple that are cruising. They're not even cruising actually. They live here and they're living on their boat, but they've been cruising the Caribbean for like 20 years. There's this awesome Texan couple, and they've got the thickest Texan accent you could ever, a Texan craw he called it. And they're just lovely, and they've been so helpful, like everything, like we just got to chatting and I mentioned in passing that I wanted to fiberglass up a new Bimini. Boom, next day, did you want to come down to Home Depot and get some of this stuff? And he showed me like the foam board, showed me the fiberglass, helped me out with heat guns and resin, and took me down the shops, which is a big deal here because like it's a 20 minute drive and you have to rent a car, which adds $40 to every job that you have to do, never mind if you forget something. And then, yeah, helped us out, showed me how to fiberglass, just
stood here in the beating sun, fiberglassing with us.
Just bent over backwards, and we could not possibly repay their generosity, but like, I'm just blown away. Like,
so am I. So, they've been so generous.
And I keep saying, I was like, mate, we got to, you know, we bought him beers and try to replace everything we used and try to make it up to them. And he's like, that's what cruisers do. So, I just love it. I just think it's really cool.
Thank you, cruisers.
And they're not the only ones. They're just probably the most significant thus far. But yeah, you know, Mike, if you ever watch this, mate, thank you so much.
Getting back to the spray dodger. After spending endless hours of sewing, I tried putting it on the frame. It didn't fit. So I went back to the drawing board.
Oh, hey.
Hello.
What are you doing?
Just trying to prepare the... fiberglass for painting.
Cool. What colour are we going to paint it?
Bright white. Hopefully that, like that white. A nice vibrant white. There's a lot of like, the fiberglass is a bit like your grandmother's quilt. It's like old patchwork and stuff because we couldn't get big enough rovings, but it'll look alright. I'm hoping that the joints will get lost in the bright white. You know, all the little, like,
yeah.
It's not a fantastic fiberglassing job. It's the best we could do with what we had, but I'm hoping if the vibrant white is blindingly Right. Yeah, right.
It'll blind everyone from seeing the details.
It'll blind you from the details, exactly.
Rained out. I'm so glad I spent 3 hours painting the roof of my Bimini. A vibrant white, right? White, right? White. Yeah, white. Just white. Hopefully it dried in time and there's not going to be all droplets and rubbish all over it. Kind of shut in now.
Yeah.
Let's put the kibosh on most of the work we wanted to do.
And I didn't finish my dodger. Surprise, surprise! I did almost fall in the water though, with my sewing machine, and I was really, really hoping I would so I wouldn't need to finish the job. However, I managed to save myself.
It does give us a good opportunity to check these leaking windows. Fortunately, the ones we re-bedded.
Why are you so dirty? What the hell happened?
Finally, after 6 months, I got the sea strainer out.
First oh my God.
First time I've tried, but like, so...
The sea strainer broke so long ago, like within...
Before we left America.
Yeah.
Like, the first week out of the yard, really. Because what happened is, so this little piece is on both sides. And we were, what were we doing? We were trying to clean it when we were trying to get the water maker working, thinking that it was like all clogged up. And when we took it off, it just cracked clean off this thing. So obviously there's nothing holding the top of the water sea strainer on. And so when you start your engine, all the water that's supposed to go into the engine just comes pouring out the top. So I rigged it up with this bit of wire and this cable tie, which like pinned the roof down, and it worked so well that we forgot about it.
We didn't forget about it,
it was all good.
Gotta do something about that.
Yeah, and it was only when I was screwing around with some scupper drains yesterday that I knocked it and it started leaking again, and I was like, oh, I better change that.
No.
Mad.
Get off me.
How's your progress?
It is almost there, which I never, ever, ever thought I would see this day. Exactly. I never thought I'd say that and genuinely actually believe it. Well, every day I bloody believe that I would be finished. But today might be the day. I finally finished the dodger. I'm so exhausted and it's just like, why are you not happy? I'm bloody ecstatic underneath my exhaustion.
It looks fantastic. It looks epic. I'm indescribably happy and proud. You have smashed this so much.
If you don't look closely, it doesn't look too bad. That's the main thing, if you don't look too closely.
Go and look at it from the front, because that's the good side. Oh, thank you for one.
This has been my competition staring at me every single day. Oh, look at it. It's attached.